when I say tool, I mean that the software we build is kind of a tool, and sometimes we refer to all those tools as features in our software. It's features that help people do things in order to reach goals. And where Paul focuses is on the doing things, the tasks that people need to do. Let's go through this model one more time with an example. If I've got this flower, and I want to plant it in the ground, what I need is a hole. And the thing that I'll do is dig the hole. And if I know that I need to dig a hole, I can find any number of tools that will satisfy. But Paul's strategy is to say, as a gardener, I want to dig a hole so that I can plant a flower. His strategy isn't to say, as a gardener, I want a shovel so that I can dig a hole to plant a flower. He holds his options open because he knows at budget time he might have enough money for that kind of tool, or maybe a bit better one, or maybe a really good one, or maybe a really fabulous tool for digging holes. And maybe all this digging is a little tiring, and maybe we should hire someone else to dig the hole. And so maybe the way I want to get this done is to have it outsourced. And at the end of the day, I may not have enough money for any of that stuff. And the feature that I need to build may just barely satisfy it, but maybe I can ship it. But by holding my options open, I can make that kind of choice late. One more. This is the last strategy. This is Pete and Roger. They look better as they age than Paul does. And they've got a problem. I guess not a lot of people have heard that magic bus song, so for the older people in the room, try and describe the 60s to the younger people. Maybe it was the early 70s. They all run together. But they want a bus, and they know that they can't have it, not with the money they've got. And they have a strategy for building things up that'll allow them to get it for the money that they've got. So they're going to leverage iterations to build things up. So Pete and Roger prepare a backlog for their bus. It has some simple things like engine, transmission, brakes, suspension, seats, steering wheel, and beer cooler. And if you're Pete and Roger, you know that all of these things are equally important. We couldn't possibly ship a bus without an engine, transmission, and beer cooler. It has to have all of these features. The experienced agilist says, hey, you need to prioritize those, as if one was more important than the other. They realize, they know they need all of these things, but they've got another strategy for getting everything they want. They need all those. And they know that all buses don't cost the same. It's not as though we could build a bus that just had the engine and the cheaper one doesn't have brakes. They know that the cheaper, they can get a cheap bus or a moderately priced bus or a much higher priced bus. And the thing that makes these buses different is some kind of, they've got more. They've got a bigger engine. They've got better brakes. They've got more seats. They've got cooler tinted glass. And I'm going to use the term quality to talk about this. Now, quality in software development often refers to whether something has bugs or doesn't have bugs. But for people who, when you're evaluating a product, quality is sometimes the characteristics the product has, the features the product has, how you feel about using it. I always have to tell a story about my two cars. I have one car that's an American car that I just hate. It is crap. This I drive the car, it feels like crap. I refuse to wash it. And one of my sad stories is my house was broken into a few years ago, and they stole a lot of stuff, and they found the keys to this car, and they took the car, and they drove it away. only thing I got back was this car. So I have this car, and the problem with the car is that it runs every day and it does not break down. And I have my other car, which is a German car. It feels great to drive, and I love it, and I love driving it, and because my wife has the kids and it has the child seats in it, I don't get to drive it that much, and she gets to drive it all the time, and I'm envious. And that thing goes into the shop every single year, and it costs a lot to fix. But I love that German car because it's such higher quality. So it's quality means something different, and so get some definitions, different definitions of quality when you're thinking about a product in your head. So let's look at the things that make up quality, and this is the heuristic that Pete and Roger use. When I've got a feature of a product, it's got something that's necessity, that it's something I absolutely need. So the characteristic of an engine is it go and it drives you and push the car forward. It has some flexibility or things that make it a little bit better. I used to have a car that had a turbo engine, and that was kind of allowed me to use the engine a little bit differently. When I punched on the gas pedal, the turbo kicked in, and it was faster, and it did some things a little bit nicer. It was still only a four-cylinder engine, but the turbo made it nicer. There are characteristics of safety, things that make my car safer to use. Things like anti-locking brakes make my car safer to use, but I could get by with regular drum brakes. And then there are other things that just make the car nicer. Comfort, luxury, and performance. Bigger engines that make it faster. Leather seats that make it more luxurious. And better design and positioning of things on the dashboard and in the interior of the car that make it more comfortable. These are the heuristics that they use for software. So when they look at software, they say, what's absolutely necessary? What do users have to do to perform the task they're trying to perform? Flexibility, what are alternative ways they want to do it? What are additional data fields they might want to capture, additional things they might want to do with the software? Those are separate things for them that we can add on to a little bit later. What is safety? Safety means maybe better validation rules that protect the user from entering bad data or protect our business from bad data getting into the database. Can we not do a few of those, and maybe we get some ugly error messages instead of some better validation rules in some cases? And then finally, comfort, luxury, and performance. When we're talking about that in terms of software, comfort means we try harder to make the software more usable, and there are things that we add to the software to make it more usable. Luxury is it's sexier to look at. It has cool animations. Things fade out instead of just snapping off the screen. And performance, I have hotkeys that allow me to move faster in the software. I work on the back end of the software to make it perform better. There are characteristics for every feature in our software that we can slice up into elements of necessity and flexibility and safety and comfort, luxury, and performance. And Roger and Pete know this, and they know that they will start building their software by just making sure they take care of the necessity first. They've learned this the hard way because in past projects that they ran, they might start the project with some number of features and start to iteratively develop and say, we can think of the best version of this feature we want, so we'll develop the best version of feature number 1 and 2, and in the first iteration we might get all of 1 and some of 2 done, and the second iteration we get all of 2 and some of 3, and so on, and by the end of the project, they end up getting a bus that has no brakes. And it isn't good. It doesn't ship. It's missing a whole feature in one that's just partly built. That's no good. They know that they can start, they know about iteration. They know that they can start with they're not building buses. They're building software. They're